So good morning friends, today we will learn about a very good topic, that is organ transplantation, and we will just consider some just main general points and the golden points about organ transplantation, because it is not usually studied in MBBS level, so it is mostly the PG level for our pre-PG examination. We will just consider some golden points here. Let's quickly move on towards some general points. In general points we have a NOTO. NOTO is the National Organ Tissue Transplant Organization in our India, in our country. And there's an organ donation day that is celebrated on the 13th of August every year. And the purpose of this, the organ donation day, is to motivate the normal human beings to donate the organ, as well as to understand the value of organ donation in the life of an individual. They motivate the peoples to donate the organs. And here the NOTO act as an apex body at the country level of the India. It control all the activities and coordination of the organ and tissue registration in our country. So it acts as an apex body. And under all these things, the other functions happens. And there is a also known as the Human Organ Donation Act 2011. From there, all of these things has happened. Now let's consider the next point. We already are aware about the type of graft rejections: hyperacute graft rejections, acute graft rejections, and the chronic graft rejections. So let's consider some the first part, that is the hyperacute graft rejection. Usually it occurs between minutes to hours, and note that it's a type 2 hypersensitivity reaction. So that means type 2 is because of mostly the preformed antibodies. And the most characteristic part of this is there is a intravascular thrombosis. That means in histology, when we see, there is a neutrophilic infiltration and the thrombotic occlusion of the capillaries. As you can see in the diagram here, there is a thrombotic occlusion. The diagram of a kidney transplant patient, there is a occlusion in the capillaries because of the thrombosis, and mostly this occurs in the kidney transplant patients, because the type the hyperacute graft rejection is mostly in the kidney transplanted patients. Heart and liver are relatively resistant, they will have other kind of reactions. So here it is of hyperacute graft rejections. Now we have acute graft rejections. It can be both, actually. It is cellular also, it is also antibody mediated. So that type 4 hypersensitivity, and along with this it is also a type 2 hypersensitivity. That means there is a role of both antibody and the cell mediated immunity in the rejection of the graft, and mostly it occurs from days to weeks. So here it is the acute graft rejections, and here you can see because of two main mechanisms, the cell mediated and the antibody mediated rejections. In the cell mediated part, we have tubulitis, endothelitis, and in antibody mediated, there is a inflamed inflammation of glomeruli and the peritubular capillaries with deposition of CD. There is a C4D. It's a kind of protein that got deposited in this thing. As you can see in the diagram here, there's a deposition of the C4D protein in the peritubular capillaries. So it's a question that is asked in exam according to pathology point of view. So now let's move on to the chronic graft rejection. In the chronic graft rejection, it is from months to years. And in this, mostly it is a kind of type 4 hypersensitivity. That means it's only a cellular kind of reaction. So in this cellular reaction, we have intimal thickening with inflammation, glomerulopathy, peritubular capillaritis, interstitial fibrosis, tubular atrophy, like these things. And they're characterized by the myointimal proliferation of the graft arteries, leading to the ischemia and the fibrosis. So these are the type of graft rejections. Now let's move on some main key golden points about the HLA matching. We all know about the HLA. It mostly found on the chromosome number 6p, and mostly of two types, HLA type 1 and type 2. The type 1 has a main important role in the graft rejections. Now let's consider some few points. In the kidney transplant, at least 50% of HLA have to be matched. In case of kidney, the 50% of the HLA have to be matched. Second point is, in the HLA matching, there are some organs in which the HLA matching is not required. The most important, we all can know that it is cornea. We usually don't require HLA matching. Some other organs also, it is liver, it is lung, and heart. Don't just get confused by this. HLA matching is required, but usually there are also some other factors also that balance the other part, because there are some priority other things also that prioritize the transplant of these three organs. HLA matching is considered, but not as much important as kidney. The kidney is very important, so there is a HLA matching, 50% has to be matched, but as compared to these three organs, there is less matching of the HLA. So we usually consider other factors also for the transplant of these three organs also. And the most important last point is, the most important HLA is HLA-DRB1. It is mostly required for the transplant survival of the patient. So now let's move on to the next part. Organ preservation. Once we have taken out the organ from the donor, so we have to keep preserve it by some solution or by some kind of decreasing the temperature so that it does not get damaged or destroyed. So in the liver, pancreas, kidney can be successfully preserved for up to 2 days by flushing the organ with the University of Wisconsin solution. It is also known as UW solution. There is a solution, so it usually preserve the organs so that from the donor, once we have taken out from the donor and from the recipient, the organs should not damage. So we put mostly the organ into a solution, first clean it, and then we got refrigerated so that the organ is not damaged. So now let's consider what are the things that are component of the UW solution, that is University of Wisconsin solution. Let me write the spelling. University of Wisconsin, writes about the Wisconsin is WISCONSIN. So what are components of the UW solution? It's a lactobionate and raffinose. It minimizes the cell swelling. The next component is hydroethyl starch. It preserves the extracellular space expansion, prevention of the extracellular space expansion. Then we have a glutathione, as you all know, it's an antioxidant. Then we have a allopurinol. It acts as a free radical scavenger. And last we have adenosine. It act as a precursor for energy metabolism. One article I have read in around 2012, there's some recent trial that they use some solution by which the antibodies, the antigens which are on the surface of the organs, the donor organs, they get washed off, so that there's no reaction in case of once we transplant it into the recipient, there's no rejection of the graft. I think it's mostly in the trial now, but not in not just in the use now, but it's a trial. I have read in the article around 2012, they use the solution to dissolve all the surface antigens of the organs, and so there's a chances of rejection is got decreased. Now let's see one important thing also. In case of preservation, we have a part of like some amputated part. The amputated digits are mostly clean in the saline solution. Don't think it's not a tap water, it's a saline solution. We first clean it with the saline solution, the amputated part. Then we put it into wrap into a moist part, moist gauze. After wrapping into the dry plastic bag, we place it on the bed of the ice so that it got preserved. Let's consider some few important points. There are some optimal cold storage time so that the organs can be stored up to a limited hours, and let's consider some point. For kidney, the optimal hour of storage is less than 18 hours. For liver, it is less than 12 hours. For pancreas, it is less than 10 hours. And for heart, it is less than 3 hours. Lastly, for lung, it is less than 3 hours. So these are some optimal storage time for these organs, up to which these organs can be stored for some time. Now let's move on some very important part, that is a kidney transplant. In a kidney transplant, so what usually consider is two types of donors. We have cadaveric donors and we have a live patient donors. So in the cadaveric patient donors, the organ can be stored up to 24 hours. In the live patient donors, the organ can be the organ have to be transplanted within 3 to 4 hours once we have taken out from the live donor. The surgery usually take 2 to 3 hours each from taking from the donor and transplanting into recipient. Each takes 2 to 3 hours. In the donor part, we usually remove the kidney by assisted laparoscopic. By assisted laparoscopic technique. In the recipient part, we insert the kidney by the laparotomy. You can see here the diagram. The transplanted part is mostly put around the iliac fossa by connecting all this ureter, the vein and the artery part. Now let's move on some very important question. A 40-year-old man underwent a kidney transplant. 2 months after transplantation, he developed a fever and a features of suggestive of bilateral diffuse the bilateral diffuse interstitial pneumonia. So question is, which of the following is the most likely agent? And first note that what are the common causes of end stage renal disease for that we have to transplant the kidney. So the common causes is, first of all, it is diabetes mellitus, Then we have the hypertension. And lastly, we have the glomerulonephritis. So these are the most common causes for which we have to transplant the kidney. And this usually cause the end stage renal disease for which we have to transplant the kidney. One point also note here that we, after the transplant of kidney, we usually use the immunosuppressant so that there is a decreased chances of rejection. But still also after transplant, there are chances of infection and other most complications like surgical or medical. So now let's consider some common infections which occur mostly after the kidney transplantation. The question usually asks on these things. So you have to remember these. These are very important. We have early phase infections. We have middle phase. And the late phase. So in early phase, it mostly occurs within 1 month. In the middle phase, it mostly occurs after in between 1 to 4 months. And the late phase, it mostly occurs after 6 months. So in early phase, it mostly, like first we consider the urinary tract. So in urinary tract, the most commonly infection in early phase is caused by the E. coli and Klebsiella. In the middle phase, in urinary tract, the most common infection is caused by the CMV. Note here, the CMV is the most common infections occurring after organ transplantation. CMV is very important. In the late phase, it is caused by other bacterial infections. So after urinary tract, the other organ affected is the lung. So in lung, the early phase infection is caused by the Legionella. In middle phase, it is caused by CMV again and Aspergillus. And in late phase, it is caused by mucor, Aspergillus and the nocardia. And the other organ affected is the CNS. Note here, the CNS in early phase, it is not affected by any organism. It is affected mostly in the middle phase, which is Listeria meningitis. And the next one in the late phase, it is mostly caused by CMV retinitis and Listeria. So these are some common infections mostly occurring after kidney transplant. So now let us consider some other organs that are transplanted. The one is liver. In the liver, there is some extended disease donor criteria. That means the patient can still donate blood if the person has some problems, like if the patient has mild to moderate steatosis. Next is hepatitis C is positive. Next is age more than 65 years of age. Next is hepatitis B, core antibody positive. And last is non-heart beating donor. One important point to be noted is biliary atresia is the most common indication for liver transplant in the pediatric patient. So in pediatric patients, most common cause is biliary atresia. Now let's move on. I have mentioned one table here. It's a very important table. It involves all of the organs which are mostly affected once it is transplanted, like systemic infection, systemic effects, organ donation, lung, kidney, liver, heart, GIT, and the CNS part. which is mostly affected once once there is solid organ transplantation. So these are the mostly common organs which are affected once we have transplanted the organs. Note here, CMV infection is the most common causes in all of these things. Like CMV is there also. Other includes listeria, pneumocystis infections. So you have to learn this whole table, which is very important.